breakaway is increasing its lead over the yellow jersey, but there's no worry as it contains no big guns for the overall standings. He's a good climber. He's a pure climber, able to follow the very best when he's in shape.
Okay.
His best chance of victory is to try a break away from far out.
You must constantly try to shelter from the wind so as not to consume energy. This is what allows a rider to edge clear at the end of the race. When going downhill, the aerodynamic position is useful to increase speed without expending energy.
The gap isn't changing much.
The front of the race is 2 kilometers from the summit.
A good ruler with not too bad a punch. He should still try to get away before the finish because he's not so fast in a sprint. The descent from the Portillon isn't long, but it's technical. The riders will have to be careful. The gap with the yellow jersey is melting away. The escapees will have difficulties going all the way. If he wants to take points for the polka dot jersey, he must break away.
Here's the positions over the last climb.
He's one of the very best climbers, capable of accelerating on any summit climb.
Understood.
A teammate is beginning to lose touch.
Understood.
Guys, don't forget to protect our leader. Communication is important. That's why we have team comm. He's gone down. His teammates will no doubt wait for him. Collective fall. It may create gaps. It doesn't seem to be a good day for him. He's being distanced.
The head of the race will soon begin the Col de Pelsourde climb. This is one of the great classics of the Tour de France, and the riders know it well. Its slope is 7% on average, over 13 kilometers, and it's classified as first category, the same as the two that follow.
Okay, I'll follow any attack. Okay. Understood.
He's the best placed in the overall standings amongst those at the head of the race. Yellow jersey is 1 minute 30 away from you.
Understood.
You're 1 minute ahead of the yellow jersey. You have 30 seconds lead on the yellow jersey. You are 2 kilometers from the summit. Watch your opponents. The peloton is 2 kilometers from the summit. We need to score points for the polka dot jersey. It's essential if we want to strengthen our position as leader. Here's the positions over the last climb. Well done! You took the last climb. It prevents our competitors from stealing too many points. It is not always a good idea to be too many in a breakaway, as the others will not necessarily want to cooperate with us. They're riding hard behind. This isn't the moment to relax. The end of the stage is not far off. Stay awake. It will soon start to move in the peloton.
The riders will now tackle the Col de Val-Luro-Azé, a fairly short but very steep climb where the most adventurous can start attacking.
Understood.
Percentages are very high, right from the foot of the pass.
Thank you.
He's an excellent climber who must be watched continuously and also one of the best descenders in the peloton.
Reduce speed a bit, otherwise you'll hit the wall.
The first six score points at the top of Val Luroise.
You are 2 kilometers from the summit. Watch your opponent. Keep an eye on him. He's the best climber in the breakaway.
The descent to Saint-Lary-Soulan is to be negotiated with caution. If the first half is fairly straight, the second is quite tricky, with several hairpin bends. Riders will have to keep a clear head.
Here's the positions over the last climb. Well done! You took the last climb. It prevents our competitors from stealing too many points. For the polka dot jersey, it's your teammate who's best placed amongst those at the front of the race.
Okay, I'll put in a big acceleration. Understood.
The climb to the Platte is very steep, right from the first kilometers. It easily exceeds 10%. It's only in the last 3 kilometers that the slope becomes a little more bearable.
Hold! Another 10 kilometers to retain the jersey.
Okay, I'll follow any attack.
He's one of the favourites for the race and the undisputed leader of his team. What chant for him?
Understood.
In addition to a prestigious victory, the winner will score an additional 20 points in the climber standings.
Only 5 kilometers left for the race leaders.
Watch out! There's an attack at the head of the peloton. The lead rider has 30 seconds on the favourite. Acceleration at the front of the peloton. No falling asleep.
Okay, I'll put in a big acceleration.
The gap is 1 minute between the favourites and the guy in the front.
Breakaway is 1 kilometer from the finishing line.
He is all smiles as he climbs onto the podium. Applaud him. Here's the winner of the Saint-Gaudens Saint-Lary-Soulon stage. Congratulations to him. He really was the strongest. He fully deserves this prestige. He is in sparkling form and you can clap him loudly. Here's the yellow jersey of this Tour de France. Alberto Contador! Let's hope for his sake that things go as well in the future, but for now, he can relish the moment. He's amongst the leading riders this year. Here's the polka dot jersey of this Tour de France, Alberto Contador! It is a moment that he soon won't forget and which marks his career. Come on, let's applaud him once more.